Today on Review This Thing, we're gonna see how this Mossberg SA28 does straight out of the box. If you've been with our channel much lately, you know that we've had an absolute blast testing out the 410. We've had a Mossberg 500 and a CVA Scout that we've had a great time with. And it's been so much fun, we decided we wanted to try another sub-gauge. So this is the Mossberg SA28 Turkey Tactical. Turkey because it has this fantastic green leaf pattern, tactical because it comes with that pistol grip, SA, semi-automatic, and 28-28 gauge. I just picked this up yesterday, so we're out here today. It's got fiber optic ghost ring sights, and it still has the factory choke in it. Let's see what kind of patterns we can get with this. We got a few different loads. Let's try them all. A few things before we get started. First of all, we are not gonna shoot at 20 yards. The 410 was destroying things at 20, so we're just gonna move it on out to 40 and see what these loads get. We've gotten a lot of comments on our other videos about the fact that we're comparing different weight loads and number pellets and things like that. Now we know it's not necessarily perfect to compare 9 shot versus 9.5 because obviously there are more pellets in 9.5 because they're smaller. But I will say, we're just looking for the load we wanna hunt with. So we're comparing the loads that are out there and available to figure out the one we wanna use. Hopefully that'll help you figure out what you want to. So we're gonna start off with Rogue ammunition. This one hasn't been in any of our tests thus far. We were able to find a box of these 28 gauge. We've heard great things. Let's give them a go, see how they do. That looks like a lot. Let's see. So there we go, that is Rogue ammunition, 40 yards. Pow. So in our other test, we used a 6-inch circle because we figured that's about the size of a turkey's head. But we did learn that the 10-inch circle is kind of the standard. So we decided to go with both. We didn't want to lose our 6-inch circle, but wanted to kind of play by the rules and do a 10-inch circle too. So Rogue ammunition was pretty impressive. We have 132 pellets in 6 inches and 262 in 10 inches. And you might can see on this side, I was actually able to keep that ghost ring pretty well on target. Now I see why people have good things to say about Rogue. Pretty impressive showing out of those. Up next is Viper ammunition. You've seen it do pretty well in our other tests. We were able to get a hold of some 28 gauge. Let's see how these do. Hopefully I can keep my aim pretty good. Still a lot of pellets. Go check out the target. Alrighty, there's our Viper ammunition. You can see I probably shot a bit low. The trigger on that gun is pretty doggone tight. I gotta get used to that. Let's go count. Viper has 137 in our 6-inch circle and 281 in our 10-inch circle. Again, a pretty impressive showing out of those Vipers. You can see that my aim was a bit low on that one, but we'd still kill it. Just have to pick some pellets out of the bird. All right, next, you know if we're doing a TSS test, we gotta have the Apex in there. So let's see how they do. Telling you, this thing is nice. Shoots really well. I wish I could get that trigger to lighten up a little bit, but we'll see what we can do about that. Let's go look at our target. There's our Apex. I think I'm getting this ghost ring thing figured out. Let's go see how many pellets are in our circles. There's our Apex results. We had 63 in a 6-inch circle and 162 in a 10-inch circle. The fun thing about these tests is that you can go back and watch the other videos and see the Apex was in the top at some, a little lower in others. Just the science of it all when you put a different gun, a different choke, a different load, make sure you find what's best for you. Again though, that is a dead turkey at 40 yards, no doubt. And another load you knew we'd have to have in our test is Verdict ammunition. We've had a lot of success with these hunting the past couple years, and they've always given us great patterns. So hoping this 28 gauge will do the same. Let's see. That one packs a punch, so there's gotta be a lot of pellets out there. Let's go see. There's our Verdict ammunition target. It's just amazing to me what these smaller sub gauges can do. Let's go check it out, count how many we got. And there's our Verdict, another very impressive showing. Didn't expect anything less. We got 118 in 6 inches and 234 in 10 inches. And I did a decent job of aiming there. Next up are the Boss Tom. If you've watched a couple videos, you saw that these did really well out of the Mossberg 500 with a true lock choke. So hopefully they will do pretty well here. Let's find out. Looks pretty decent from here. Of course, they all look really good from here. But the cool part about that is that pretty much pick one of these loads, and at 40 yards, as long as you get on target, you're gonna kill that turkey. Here we go. Boss Tom. Let's go count how many pellets are in those circles. And here are our Boss Tom results. 136 pellets in 6 inches and 253 in 10 inches. So far, things have been looking really good. We're gonna finish up our test with the Salt Creek ammunition. These are brand new, just made like last week. So let's see how they do. Yet another dead turkey. Let's take a closer look. Salt Creek, dead turkey. Let's go count all these pellets and see where we're at. Another very impressive showing by these loads. I love testing all these out because people have really figured out how to do it well. We got 100 in our 6-inch and 215 in our 10-inch. The cool thing about these loads too is we wanted that compact circle, but you can see there are plenty of pellets all around. So if you do get your aim off a little bit or the turkey moves, then you're still killing that turkey. So there you have it, the Mossberg SA28 with the stock choke. Now I'm super interested to put the aftermarket chokes we've got on there and see if they can get better patterns than this. If you just want to look at the top three in terms of tightest pattern, we had Viper with 137, Boss Tom with 136, and Rogue with 132. But like I said, the others are so close, it almost seems unfair to pick a top three. If you got a Mossberg SA28 with the stock choke and you got any of these loads, go shoot them. Good chance you're gonna kill a turkey as long as you can aim. Hey, thanks for watching our Mossberg SA28 28 gauge with the stock choke TSS pattern test video. While you're here, watch a whole bunch of other videos. If you like them, give them a thumbs up, share them with your friends, comment and let us know what you think. And if you haven't, go ahead and subscribe. Also, check out our website, reviewthisthingtv.com, for deals and all sorts of other fun content.